बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। टुडे टॉपिक इज़ अबाउट द क्वांटिटी सर्वेइंग। सो द टॉपिक इज़ स्टील क्वांटिटी फॉर रेक्टेंगुलर स्लैब। सो वी आर गिवन, सो वन डायमेंशन इज़ 20 फीट एंड द अदर डायमेंशन इज़ 7 फीट। नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज़ कैलकुलेट द स्टील इन टन्स फॉर अ शोन स्लैब, इग्नोर कंक्रीट कवर एंड टेक मैन बार नंबर 4 बार एंड एट सेंटर टू सेंटर डिस्टेंस इज 6 इंचेस एंड फॉर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन बार द वैल्यूज आर नंबर 4 विद सेंटर टू सेंटर डिस्टेंस 6 इंचेस। सो फर्स्ट वी विल राइट द गिवन डेटा। एज वी आर गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन दैट द मैन बार इज नंबर 4 एंड इट्स सेंटर टू सेंटर डिस्टेंस इज 6 इंचेस। डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन बार इज आल्सो has the same values as the main bar. So we are required to find out the weight in tons. So for this we will first do the unit conversion. So for this question the units to be converted are 6 inches center to center distance and 6 inches center to center distance for distribution bar. So we will have to convert inches, 6 inches and this 6 inches into feet, because all the dimension in the diagram are in feet. So we will convert 6 inches into feet just like 6 divided by 12. So it will give the value 0.5 feet. Now we can proceed. Solution. So we will start from the distribution bar. So for distribution bar, we will first point that how many numbers of distribution bar will be required in this slab. Very important thing is that in which direction we will put distribution bar and in which direction main bar will be. So the distribution bar will always be in the longer direction. So this is the direction in which we will consider distribution bar. So in longer direction we will put the distribution bar, and in shorter direction we will always put main bars. Now in solution we will first find the number of bars for distribution bars. So for distribution bar the formula is given is that the total distance is divided by center, its center to center distance plus 1. Now the formula is for distribution bar, so we will put that direction, that distance here and which we are going to install or put the main bar. This is the direction on which the distribution bar lies. So distribution bar lie on shorter direction. So this distance is equal to 7. So we will put directly 7 divided by center to center distance, which is already converted into feet. 7 divided by 0.5 plus 1 is equal to, so its calculation will give 15. So we are going to find out the total length. So this is the total length of distribution bar, a length of one bar multiply by number of bars. So the length of one distribution bar starts from here and ends at this point. So it means that the length of one distribution bar is 20 feet. For total length of distribution bar, we will multiply 20 feet multiply by its number. So by putting the values in the formula, we will get length of one bar 20 feet multiply by 15, which is the number of bar. Already we find it. It will give the value of 300 feet. Now for weight in kgs, for distribution bar we have the formula d square divided by 52.9 multiply by its total length. So here we will put the number of bar. So the number of bar for a distribution bar is number 4 bar. So it means that we will put 4 square divided by 52.9 multiply by, and the total length of the bar is 300 feet. So it will give the value is equal to 90.737 kilogram. So the weight of distribution bar in kilogram is 90.737 kilogram. Now we will find out the value of main bar. Now the second step is, so secondly in this question we have to find the weight of main bar. First we will find out the number of main bars, which is equal to total distance divided by its center to center distance plus 1. So here we can see in this diagram that main bar which lies on the longer side, so it means that the total distance is 20 feet. So 20 feet is the required distance in which the main bars will lie. These are the main bars, and these bars lies on this direction. So it means that the total distance is 20 feet, which is required for the main bars. So here we will put 20 feet divided by its center to center distance is 6 inches, which we already converted into feet, which is 6 divided by 12. So it means that 0.5. So here from calculation we find out that its value is 41 bars. So the number of main bars is 41 bars. Now the length of main bar. So for length of the main bar we know that we have the formula, length of one main bar multiply by number of bar. Now by putting the values, so in this diagram we see very clearly that the length of one main bar is equal to 7 feet, because the main bar starts from this point and ends at this point. So it means that this side is 7 feet. So the length of the main bar will be definitely 7 feet. So 7 feet multiply by, and number of main bars are 41. So put 41 here and we will get 287 number of bars, 287 feet. Now we will proceed towards the weight of the main bar. So for weight of the main bar, the formula is d square divided by 52.9 multiplied by total length. So here we will put the value bar number which is mentioned in the question. So here we will put the value of which is given in the question for the main bar is 4. So the main bar is number 4 and center to center distance is 6 inches. So we will put here 4 square divided by 52.9 multiply by LT. So total distance, LT means total distance, which is 287, total length. So 287, we will get 86.805. So it means that this value is in kilogram, because this formula gives us the value in kilogram. And as per requirement, you can also convert it into pound by multiplying this value with 2.204. Now total weight will be weight of main bar plus weight of distribution bar, which is, so weight of the main bar is 86.805 kg plus weight of the main bar, which is 90.737 kilogram. 90.737 kilogram 177.543 kilogram. So this is the total weight of the steel which is used in this slab, but this value is in kilogram. So this is the total value of steel in kilogram which is used in this slab. But in question we are required to find out the value in tons, so we have to convert this value in ton. So for conversion we will divide this value by 1000. 177.543 kilogram divided by 1000, because we know that 1 ton is equal to 1000 kilograms. So that's why we divide the value in kilogram by 1000. So it will give the value is equal to 0.1775 tons. So this is the required answer. For any problem or query, you can approach me through my Gmail, and also you can write in comment section. Thank you.